Voices of unknown origin appearing on radio frequencies were first noticed in Scandinavia by the military in the 30s and were put down at the time to secret Nazi transmitters. But the voices spoke in unknown and mixed tongues, and after the war, no records of secret Nazi transmissions ever came to light. The voices didn't stop after the war, but their rapidity and their transient nature precluded study. That is, until the tape recorder came into common usage in the 50s. A group of radio hams in Chicago studied the strange transmissions, male and female voices speaking in polyglot mode and lyrical tones. But it was not until 1959 that a Russian-born Swedish citizen, radio and TV producer and filmmaker, Friedrich Jakobsen, noticed intrusions on tape and commenced his own systematic study. A disturbing fact soon emerged. The voices zeroed in onto the Swede, addressing him by name, revealing a knowledge of his thoughts and actions, and claiming to be the voices of deceased friends and acquaintances. The news spread rapidly, and soon experimenters and scientists all over the world were attempting to duplicate Jurgensen's work. The effect on parapsychologists was dramatic. Accustomed to investigating the blind forces of the poltergeist and endless and somewhat boring parlor and dice-guessing experiments, they were confronted at once with living voices which answered back. Taken by surprise, the British parapsychologists, without conducting experiments, rejected the objectivity of the voices, explaining them as breakthrough from taxis, police messages, or simply mechanical noises in the tape recorder. But their European counterparts were more cautious, and possibly with greater technical resources, they soon found out that they were indeed confronted with voices of unknown origin on tape.
Thank you. Thank you. Preacher man says it's the end of time. Says that America's rivers are going dry. The interest is up. The stock market's down. You guys gotta be careful walking around here this late at night. No, we don't, ma'am, I'm sorry. This is the perfect place to get jumped.
But do you think the end of the world is coming?
No. So says the preacher man, but I don't go by what he says.
Thank you. Car's on fire, and there's no driver at the wheel. And the sewers are all muddied with 1,000 lonely suicides. And a dark wind blows. The government is corrupt, and we're on so many drugs with the radio on and the curtains drawn. We're trapped in the belly of this horrible machine, and the machine is bleeding to death. The sun has fallen down, and the billboards are all leering, and the flags are all dead at the top of their poles. It went like this. The buildings toppled in on themselves. Mothers clutching babies picked through the rubble and pulled out their hair. The skyline was beautiful on fire. Twisted metal stretching upwards. Everything washed in a thin orange haze. I said, "Kiss me, you're beautiful. These are truly the last days." You grabbed my hand, and we fell into it like a daydream or a fever.
Thank you.
further down. For sure it's the Valley of Death. I open up my wallet, and it's full of blood.
aware, catching you off guard. You don't understand what's being said.
This day of the peace, when there is no peace, shall overtake you as a thief. that leads up to this time of peace, when there is no peace, is what leads up to the return of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Yeshua Messiah, Jesus the Christ, the Lamb of God.
Dreams of endless landscape.